All right, and we are back, bros. All right, Kill Shot is today. You guys, a lot of you guys came into the live last night and was like, bro, Kill Shot. I know, Kill Shot today. All right, chill out. All right, listen, if you are new here, please like and subscribe. The more that you like this content, the more that I know that you specifically would like to see more of this specific type of content, okay? All right, and we went ahead and got the lyrics pulled up. Ready for this? Yes? Let's jump into it.
You sound like a bitch, bitch.
Shut the fuck up.
Your fans become your haters.
You done? Rihanna just hit me on a text.
All right, listen, basically, bro, everything he just said basically kind of summed up the entire track from MGK, basically, except he's not pointing out the fact that he's old, right? He should have, in the introduction, he at least should have said, yeah, I'm old or some shit, bro. I don't know. Let's get it.
I'm doing this once.
Rihanna just hit me on a text. Last night I left hickeys on her neck. Wait, you just dissed me? I'm perplexed.
But I thought that he couldn't get her number, MGK. Oh, but she contacted him? Oh. Alright.
On a text. Last night I left hickeys on her neck. Wait, you just dissed me? I'm perplexed. Insult me in a line, compliment me on the next. Damn, I'm really sorry.
Yep. His whole song was a literal compliment fest, right? He was basically a fluffer. I'm not going to define that, but that's basically what he was doing for himself. He was fluffing the whole situation for this, the climax. Let's go.
You want me to have a diss me? I'm perplexed. Insult me in a line, compliment me on the next. Damn, I'm really sorry you want me to have a heart attack. Was watching 8 Mile on my Nauta track. Realized I forgot to call you back. Here's that autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on a starter cap.
Wait. Okay. That's a line from what, Stan, I think it was? Where like the Stan was the like the crazy fan, right? But the real fan was either the brother, I think, right? And that's who got the starter cap? So your daughter is even a bigger fail. Oh, he got jokes, bro. Hey, but listen, you brought the daughters into the game, though. You did that, sir. Let's go.
Realized I forgot to call you back. Here's that autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on a starter cap. Stand, son. Listen, man, dad isn't mad, but how you...
Dad isn't mad. Exactly, bro. See? Listen, MGK, I'm going to talk to MGK, okay? MGK, sir. What you did was basically, you acted like you were talking to your father, bro. That's what it looked like. And I'm glad that he picked up on that, because that man, listen, all right? He was acting like he was, you know, talking to his parent. Like a frustrated child of sorts. Let's go.
Realized I forgot to call you back. Here's that autograph for your daughter. I wrote it on a starter cap. Stand, son, listen, man, dad isn't mad, but how you gonna name yourself after a damn gun and have a man bun?
I mean, I've never seen anyone gangster with a man bun. I'll be honest. Have you? Let me know in the comments. Tell me one person you are fearful of that has a man bun. Alright? We're not talking about a top knot. We're not talking about no samurai shit, right? Because that's something different. I'm scared of death of a samurai. I never want to meet him in my life, bro. No Harikari over here, bro. Right? None of that. Oh, maybe MGK has the man bun, right? To be kind of like the top knot that the samurai wore. And so since he wanted to basically commit like ritualized suicide by going against Eminem in that last track, right? Maybe that's why he wears the man bun, for the purpose of, like, you know, Harikari and, like, immortalizing and, you know, being something that he... I don't know, bro. I'm trying to quantify the man bun, bro. I don't think it has anything to do with the samurais, bro. Or Harikari, honestly. I don't know, bro, but... I don't know. Maybe he's dissing himself with the man bun. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Let's go.
Auto cap.
stand, stand, son, listen, man, dad isn't mad, but how you gonna name yourself after a damn gun and have a man bun?
He named himself after George Kelly, right? Machine Gun Kelly is George Kelly. Funny enough, George Kelly died of a heart attack, right? And if you look, I don't know if this is on purpose, but like, Eminem pointed out, he says, damn, I'm really sorry you want me to have a heart attack. I wonder if that has anything to do with the reason why he's named after a gun. Maybe. I think Eminem is intelligent enough to do something like that, but we'll see. Let's go.
Mad, but how you gonna name yourself after a damn gun and have a man bun? Giant smoke, eyes open, undeniable, supplying smoke, got the fire stoked.
you woke the giant. You woke a sleeping giant, bro. Eminem was just chilling, bro. You poking the bear, bro.
You got me in a scope, but you grazed me. I say one.
In a scope, isn't that in a scope? Is that Interscope Records? Hold on.
Called it in a scope, and you Swayze. Your reply.
Interscope.
I got the crowd yelling woo. So before you die, let's see who can out petty who with your corny lines. Slim your roll, Al Kelly. Ooh.
Nah, bro. Eminem's gonna definitely out petty you, bro. No doubt.
Yelling woo, so before you die, let's see who can out petty who with your corny lines. Slim your roll, Al Kelly, ooh, but I'm
Al Kelly, ooh. That hurts my feelings. Ah, type of shit.
45 and I'm still outselling you. By 29, I had 3 albums that it blew. Now let's talk about something I don't really do.
Okay.
Going someone's daughter's mouth stealing food. But you're a fucking molehill. Now I'ma make a mountain out of you. Ho chill, acting like you put the chrome barrel to my bone marrow. Gonna bitch, you ain't a bow and arrow, say you're running.
Oh, you tough? You're a gunner? Bro, you're nothing but a... You're not even a bow and arrow. So what exactly are you... What type of weapon were you? A slingshot? What's happening, bro? He's a slingshot. You're acting like you put a gun to my head with that weak sauce diss track you put out when you complimented me. Basically is what he's saying. You act like you put a chrome barrel to my bone marrow. Gunner, bitch. You ain't even a bow and arrow. You're a slingshot. Ooh. Alright.
Ho chill, acting like you put the chrome barrel to my bone marrow. Gonna bitch, you ain't a bow and arrow. Say you run up on me like a phone bill, spraying lead.
Say you like you're running up a phone bill, right? All he's doing is talking shit, basically. All that talking he's doing, right? Spraying lead. Alright, let's get it.
Playing dead, that's the only time you hold still. Are you eating cereal?
Hold on. Playing dead is the only way you hold still and hold steel. It sounds like feels like a homophone. Let's go.
Cereal or oatmeal? Lead, playing dead, that's the only time you hold still. Are you eating cereal or oatmeal? What the fuck's in the bowl?
Exactly. Why was he why was he standing in the middle of the street, right? Rapping and eating out of like disposable cutlery, right? And like a paper bowl, right? What the hell was in that bowl, bro? The video was too low quality to actually see what was actually transpiring within a bowl, bro. So if you were trying to prove a point, in the comments they said he was consuming M&Ms, but was that proven? Did he say that? I don't know. Like, it could be a theory because it would make sense a little bit. But why would you be eating M&Ms out of a bowl with a spoon? See, so like, I don't know. I'm aware that Eminem, no, not Eminem. I'm aware that MGK is a little awkward, bro. But I don't know if that he would be just like eating M&Ms out of a bowl with a plastic spoon. I don't know. I don't get it, bro. It was just weird, bro. And I'm glad Eminem realized that it was all equally as weird.
Dad, that's the only time you hold still. Are you eating cereal or oatmeal? What the fuck's in the bowl, milk, Wheaties or Cheerios? Because I'm taking a shit in them, Kelly. I need reading material. Dictionary.
I need reading material. Dictionary. Why? Because MGK legitimately said that all he does is read the dictionary. And what is the exact issue with that? I mean, why not, bro? Get a mastery of, the English language. Or any language, honestly. Read the dictionary. No problems. Let's go.
Cheerios, cause I'm taking a shit in them, Kelly. I need reading material. Dictionary. Yo, Slim, your last 4 albums suck. Go back to recovery. Oh, shoot, that was 3 albums ago. What do you know? Oops. Know your facts before you come at me, little goof. Luxury. Oh, you broke, bitch. Yeah, I had enough money in 02 to burn it in front of you, ho. Younger me.
Oh, I had so much money in '02, I could just burn it in front of you. Listen, I don't think that MGK has that ever.
Luxury, oh, you broke, bitch, yeah.
But see, the thing about it is, right? He's the one bringing up the money, bro, right? MGK was the one that brought money into the equation, bro. Like, don't bring money into an equation if you're not ready to have that discussion, bro, right? Don't battle money, bro. Don't do that with Eminem. Come on.
You know, oops, know your facts before you come at me, little goof. Luxury, oh, you broke, bitch, yeah. I had enough money in '02
to burn it, bitch, in front, yeah, of
you, younger me, no, you the whack me. It's funny, but
you the whack me. Oh.
I had enough money in '02 to burn it in front of you, ho. Younger me, no, you the whack me. It's funny, but so true. I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you.
He's like, listen, I'd rather be at the end of my life, right? Exactly how I am, where I am in life, right? Versus where you were at 20 years old, which was most likely nowhere or in the beginning of his career, most likely, right? Listen, all right.
Whack me. It's funny, but so true. I'd rather be 80-year-old me than 20-year-old you. Till I'm hitting old age, still can fill a whole page with a 10-year-old's rage. Got more fans than you in your own city, little kitty, go play.
This is back to back, bro. This is back to back, bro. I got more fans than you in your own city. All right.
You can fill a whole page with a 10-year-old's rage. Got more fans than you in your own city, little kitty, go play. Feel like I'm babysitting Lil Tay. Got the ditty okay, so you spent your whole day shooting a video just to fucking dig your own grave. Got you at your own wake, I'm the Philly goat. You ain't never made a list. Next to no Biggie, no Jay, next to Taylor Swift.
No, I don't think so. Shout out to Biggie, though. Listen, I want to have mainly for to channel the energy of hip-hop, right? And respect, you brought up Biggie, respect. Nothing but respect, bro. He says he feel like he's babysitting Lil Tay, bro. Lil Tay? Lil Tay is a terrible child, all right? Have you seen her, bro? She's cursing and throwing money that's not hers. Like, she's getting her mother fired from jobs. Why, you ask? I'm glad you asked. Bro. So her mother was like a real estate agent or something like that, bro, right? And so, and for like mansions. And so the kid, Lil Tay, would go sometimes, occasionally, and like film these ridiculously trashy videos, right? Lying about the wealth, you know, fake money, things like that. It was all the big brother setting the little kid up, right? So that's how that went. So now basically, Eminem is now comparing MGK to this fraudulent child. This fraudulent terroristic child, bro. Alright, makes sense.
Wake, I'm the Philly goat. You ain't never made a list. Next to no Biggie, no Jay, next to Taylor Swift.
What top ten is MGK in the top 10 of? I'm interested, bro.
And that Iggy ho, you about to really blow Kellis. Next to no Biggie, no Jay, next to Taylor Swift. In that Iggy hole, you about to really blow, Kelly.
You're about to really blow. Okay, so I think he's saying that something reminds Eminem. Something reminds Eminem of Taylor Swift and Iggy Azalea when he looks at MGK. You're about to really blow. There's a couple of, you know. Either you're about to, like, explode from my knowledge of you, basically. From I now know who you are. I'm making you famous. You're about to blow. He could also be about to, like, perform some form of, you know, awkward diss, right? Potentially. All right, let's get it.
They'll be putting your name next to time, next to Benzino. Bye, motherfucker, like the last motherfucker saying Haley in vain. Alien.
See, I told you this, bro. Don't bring up Haley's name in songs, bro. Right? Don't do that, bro. Don't do that.
Next to time, next to Benzino, bye, motherfucker, like the last motherfucker saying Haley in vain, alien brain. Satanist, yeah. My biggest flops are your greatest hits. The game's mine.
Yep. I don't doubt that at all, bro. The worst songs that Eminem puts out most likely does higher numbers than MGK's best songs. For real. Let's go.
again, and ain't nothing changed but the lock. So before I slay this bitch, biggest flops are your greatest hits. The game's mine again, and ain't nothing changed but the lock. So before I slay this bitch, I'm gonna give Jade a kiss. Gotta wake up Labor Day.
Ooh, hold on, bro. The game is mine, and ain't nothing gonna change but the locks. The locks, as in the rap group The Locks, right? Sheik Looch and Styles P and Jadakiss. All right, we're talking hip hop. All right. Then at the same time, he's talking about a lock, right? And before I slay this bitch, I moi, because you know, like Jadakiss is like moi or some shit, like ha ha, some weird shit that Jadakiss does when he raps, right? Then at the same time, before I slay this bitch as an MGK, right? I give a kiss to Haley Jade, right? I give Jade a kiss. Bro, I'm done with this shit now, man. I don't want to do this shit anymore, bro. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, bro. This is over. We're done, bro. And people in the comments were like, yo, Killshot wasn't even all of that. Bro, do you have the lyrics in front of you? Do you see the levels of absurdity that's happening right now, bro? I don't think you guys are, bro. Man, that Jadakiss line is fire. Let's get it.
Data this. Being rich shamed by some prick using my name for clickbait in a state of bliss because I said his goddamn name. Now I got a cockback aim. Yeah, bitch, pop champagne to this. It's your moment.
Oh,
this is it.
It's your moment.
Biggest you're gonna get, so enjoy it.
This is big as you're gonna get, so enjoy it. This man is playing with your life, MGK. He's playing with your life, bro. He's not taking your life seriously.
To give you a career to destroy it.
Had to give you a career to destroy it. Run that, bro.
I cock back aim, yeah, bitch, pop champagne to this. It's your moment. This is it. As big as you're gonna get, so enjoy it. Had to give you a career to destroy it. Lethal injection, go to sleep 6 feet deep. I'll give you a beat for the effort, but if I was 3'11",
you... Bro, this cadence switch right now? Oh my god.
This is it, as big as you're gonna get, so enjoy it. Had to give you a career to destroy it. Lethal injection, go to sleep 6 feet deep. I give you a beat for the effort, but if I was 3'11", you look up to me, and for the record, you would suck a dick to fucking be me for a second.
He's like, yo, you would do anything. You would legitimately put your mouth on a man's penis if you could just be me for 1 second. Keep that in mind, young sir. All right? If he was 3'11", you would still look up to him. He is sunning you, young man. Notice how I'm now calling you young man. All right? Yo, what is this even, bro? All right? This is bad, bro. Right? Yo, R.I.P., bro.
Oh. Like a boss, like to get on my channel. Give your life to be a solidified. This motherfucking shit is like Rambo when he's out of bullets. So what good is a fucking machine gun when it's out of ammo?
None. It has no value, bro. Right? Well, it does have a value. It's a blunt instrument. You know, the materials are still hard enough to knock somebody out. But, you know, you're not doing shit, really. It's no different than a bat, then, I guess, in that instance. Yeah, dude. What's so, you know, what's out of ammo? No value, bro. None.
This motherfucking shit is like Rambo when he's out of bullets. So what good is a fucking machine gun when it's out of ammo? Had enough of this tatted up mumble rapper. How the fuck can him and I battle? He'll have to fuck Kim in my flannel. I'll give him my sandals because he knows long as I'm shady, he's going to have to live in my shadow.
All right, we're back. The only way you're going to get with Kim, because, you know, at the end, he was like, yeah, I'm just going to get with Kim, right? The only way you're going to do it is if you're me. And me, when I say me, not me personally. I mean me as an Eminem. That's what he's saying. I'm speaking from the man himself, right? I'm going to have to give you my flannel. You're going to have to dress up like me. You're going to have to be everything that I embody, right? In order to get with her, right? I'm going to give you my sandals. You can have my sandals too, bro. All of that. Then he goes on to say, to top it off, right? As long as I'm shady, he's going to have to live in my shadow. Why? Because shadows are shady. That's where the shade is, in the shadow, bro. Come on, man.
him in my flannel. I'll give him my sandals, cause he knows long as I'm shady, he's gonna have to live in my shadow. Exhausting, letting off on my offspring like a gun barrel, bitch. Get
exhausting. I'm letting off on my offspring, bro. Come on. He's sonning you, young man. You are now his son, bro. Listen to your daddy, bro. Listen to your father.
Off me, you dance around it like a. Exhausting, letting off on my offspring like a gun barrel, bitch. Get off me, you dance around it like a sombrero. We can all see you're fucking salty, cause young Gerald's balls deep inside a Halsey.
I didn't know he had anything to do with that situation, but that's a bad. I mean, listen, if G-Eazy now has your girl, was he with Halsey? Now G-Eazy is now balls deep inside of Halsey, and he's just dancing around it like a sombrero. He's like, I don't want to deal with it. I know what's happening. You are soft, young man. Run that shit.
Like a sombrero, we can all see you're fucking salty, cause young Gerald's balls deep inside a Halsey. Your red sweater, your black leather, you dress better, I rap better.
Okay. And let's get it.
Your red sweater, your black leather, you dress better, I rap better. That a death threater, a love letter, little white.
That was a love letter. Without a doubt, he basically wrote you a love letter. That's what that was. The whole shit was a love letter, bro.
You dress better, I rap better. That a death threater, a love letter. Little white toothpick thinks it's over a pick. I just don't like you, prick. Thanks for listening. Now I had an excuse on the mic to write, not a like. But really, I don't care who's in the right. But you're losing the fight, you pick. Who else wanted Kells? Attempt fails. Button L's. Fucking nails. In these coffins, they're soft as cottonelle. Kill shot, I will not fail. I'm with the doc still. But this idiot's boss pops pills and tells him he's got skills. But Kells, the day you.
His idiot's boss pop pills and tell him he got skills. Okay, he's soft as cottonelle. He's soft as ass paper, basically. All right, let's get it.
L's, fucking nails. In these coffins, they're soft as cottonelle. Kill shot, I will not fail. I'm with the doc still. But this idiot's boss pops pills and tells him he's got skills. But Kells, the day you put out a hit, the day Diddy admits that he put the hit out, they got pop kill, eh? I'm sick of you being whack and still using that motherfucking auto-tune. So let's talk about it. Talk about.
What's that shit say? Yo, hold on.
Got skills, but Kells, the day you put out a hit, the day Diddy admits that he put the hit out, they got pop kill, eh? I'm sick of you being whack.
Oh. Shit. No comment. What? What happened?
Diddy admits that he put the hit out, they got pop kill, eh? I'm sick of you being whack and still using that motherfucking auto-tune, so let's talk about it.
Yeah, bro, he definitely, listen, when MGK basically did that, he did like a hook or something, bro, and it was like the most like awkward hook I've ever heard in my entire life on some type of diss track, bro, right? You know, listen, people in the comments, they're like, yo, the best diss track ever to go against Eminem was this one. Bro, no, this was not, bro. Are you guys new to hip-hop, bro? What are you talking about? Stop playing, bro. Stop acting like you don't know who Cannabis is, bro. Cannabis was probably the closest to ever get to Eminem, bro. Right? And that's real. Let's just sit on that for a second, bro. All right? Cannabis Eminem was the best battle between Eminem and anyone else. For real, bro. All right? And if you have not heard that, you should go check that out, bro. Though that was, we're not talking no play bars, bro. All right. And MGK came at Eminem with some play bars. I think Ja Rule's diss track was probably better than MGK's. All right. Let's just start there. All right. Let's get it.
I'm sick of you being whack and still using that motherfucking auto-tune. So let's talk about it.
Yeah. That auto-tune hook on his diss track was trash, bro.
Talk about it. I'm sick of your mumble rap mouth. Need to get the cock about it before we can even talk about it.
I'm sick of your mumble rap mouth. You need to get the penis out of it before we can even talk about it. I mean, listen, because if you have a penis in your mouth, you're going to be mumbling, most likely. Is that why they rap like that? That could be. We now have an explanation to why mumble rap exists, bro. We are here now, all right? We now know why mumble rap exists. Let's get it.
Talk about it. I'm sick of your blonde hair and earrings. Just because you look in the mirror and think that you're Marshall Mathers. Marshall Mathers. Don't mean you are and you're not about it. So just leave my dick in your mouth and keep my daughter out. You fucking... Oh, and I'm just playing, Diddy. You know I love you.
I'm just playing, Diddy. You know I love you. Bro. Bro. And listen. What is there even left to say, bro? Don't come back. Don't come back again. Right? I don't understand the people in the comments, bro. Like literally. People in the comments are like, nah. Eminem's kill shot was trash, bro. Are we even listening to the same thing? People are like, yo, you're being biased. Listen, trust me when I say, if MGK came hard, I would have easily been like, all right, it was a better battle, bro. Trust me when I say, me being biased is not likely in this instance, bro. When it comes to hip hop, forget that shit. I care about bars, bro. Right? Eminem had way too many to count. While we listen to MGK's, what I count, 6, bro? And then at the same time, he's complimenting the man. I was basically done when he started complimenting him. All right? There was no way he was coming back from that, bro. Right? Like, this is the thing, bro. I don't know what generation of hip hop you guys are all coming from, right? But like, diss tracks are like no Vaseline. They're like ether. They're like this, right? You understand? Not what we just heard over there, bro. All right, that's not a diss track, bro. It's like some passive aggressive weirdo, like weird shit, bro. I don't have time for that. How do you guys have time for that? That's crazy. So listen, dudes, again, if you guys are new here, please like and subscribe. We're following along this Eminem journey, and let me know in the comments the next one of these I should be listening to from Eminem. I will get to it as soon as I possibly can, which will most likely be tomorrow, because we do Eminem every day now, right? And, yeah, dudes, enjoy the rest of your days.